physiotherapy for stroke patient. Okay, physiotherapy. First you going to make assessment, then you diagnosis, then you give a treatment. That is concept of physiotherapy, modern physiotherapeutic approach. Okay, so first I am going to assess the patient. How I will assess? Assessment on first subjective assessment. I am going to talk in patient. I am conversation with the patient. Sometimes patient unable to talk. Okay, at the time I am going to get the information from the attendants. Okay, the family members also. Okay, so subjective assessment. First, I am going to ask what is the name of the patient. Then age of the patient. Then what gender is the male or female or transgender male, whatever I mentioned. Then name, age, sex. Then what is the occupation of the patient? Okay, what is the occupation? Maybe the patient age is 70 years, means they retired teacher or retired policeman or retired army people or retired administrative level. Okay, I know about that. Which occupation is most affected in this stroke in future? I am take the records. Okay, so the purpose occupation, which occupation is affected more this? Okay, so now name, age, sex, occupation of the patient is retired people or either doing work. Okay, what the occupation is, which are the remote teacher. Okay, name, age, sex, occupation. That's all. This is a basic subject. Okay. Without this, you didn't go into next level of the assessment. You first take this assessment, then the subject assessment. Under the subject assessment, I am going to ask chief complaints. The chief complaint from patient, either from patient or attendant. Sometimes the patient is unable to talk. Okay, the stroke means some patients also having the dysphagia. So I am going to ask from the patient, what is the chief complaint? What is your problem? What is your complaint? What is your problem? So I am going to ask the patient. The patient, maybe this is the imaging, but if you go to talk to the patient, means the patient giving these words to me. I am unable to walk properly. I am unable to get up from the bed. I am unable to do the works in bedroom, in toilet activities, in hair activities. I am unable to do. I am always dependent on one person. This is acute state. Sometimes the patient chief complaint is like this. Okay, you note it. I am unable to walk independently. I am unable to do my activities of daily living. I am unable to do work. Okay, my occupation also spoiled there. Okay, so this is like you write it all. You get the information from the patient. You go out this department. Okay, what is the chief complaint? Patient told you write it. Otherwise, patient is unable to. You go to ask the attendant. What is the problem of the patient? Yes, sir. The patient is always. Always lie in the bed. He is unable to walk independently. He is always having some assistance, toilet activities, either bathing. Okay, so like that, attendant also tell about the patient. That is also come under the chief complaint. Okay, so what is the complaint of that patient? That is we are not here. Okay, right. Next subject assessment. This after chief complaint, we go to first medical history. Medical history. Maybe diabetic patient, how many years, what are the drugs he is taking? Okay, so past medical history, you note with the normal diabetic. of hypertension. More than 10 years, he is a hypertension person. Okay, so how many years he is take the drug? How many years he is having the disease? Okay, you note here. There is a possible history. Any surgical history also. Sometimes some patients are dealing with the uterus. Okay, surgical removal of the uterus. Sometimes angiopectoralis. Some heart disease also come to the patient. So he is taking the drug, not a hypertension. Any other heart disorder, any other disease like that. Okay, any autoimmune disorder, rheumatoid arthritis, any including the syndrome like that. He is taking treatment previous years. Okay, so you note here that past medical history. Okay, now after the past medical history, you note the present medical history. Now what happens? Hypertension. Drugs for hypertension. Definitely he is taking drugs for hypertension, stroke. So what are the drugs are taking? Giving the physician notes. Okay, you note it here, present medical history. Okay. The next subjective assessment, these are the subjective assessment. I complete the subjective assessment. Next I go to objective assessment. Objective assessment means I use some objects, I assess the patient. Okay, that's all. Understand? Objective assessment. Objective assessment. I go to use some assessment. First, I observe patient. So, on observation, how the patient is walk, how the patient walk, how the patient talk. I am going to observe. So body build. I observe the body build. Then posture. I observe the patient posture. Then gait. Then external appliances. External appliances. Any external appliances use this. I note here. Okay, body build. Some the patient is obese or athletic or normal body. Okay, now I note here body build. Obese, normal, athletic body. Okay, then posture. The posture is what is the posture? Patient is I am lying posture or standing posture or sitting posture. I just note. Okay, maximum of patient I see the patient is lying. Okay. So the posture is lying. Supine lying. Okay. Gait. Definitely gait is difficult. That is circumflexion gait or difficult. Is patient unable to walk in acute stage. So gait is difficult. Difficulty not normal. Okay. Then external appliances. The patient use sometimes walker. Walker quadruped stick. Okay. Sometimes the patient use a finger extensors, string like extensor, diamond string like that, finger extensors. Sometimes he is used cuff and collar because shoulder subluxation is occur the acute stage. So prevent measures they use cuff and collar. So I just note here cuff and collar. Affected side they use the cuff and collar is affected. Right side affected means right side they use. Cuff and collar, quad pole stick or external appliances, means they are used in the patient. I just observe in my observation, body build, posture, weight, external appliances. That's all. Next, on palpation. On palpation. Okay, I am going to touch the patient. Okay. On palpation, how the muscle is there, how is the nature of the position of the limb, how is the texture of the skin. Okay, I am going to touch the patient